Hey guys, Janet here with Radiant Wanderings. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and stay a while. And as always, if you find anything in here helpful or useful, please give a big thumbs up. And do hit that notification bell so you get notified when future videos drop. If I go too fast or you need any of the links I mentioned, check the description below. I will have a link there to my blog post with all of this information and those links for you, and you can pin that for later. All right, you guys, I have 5 reasons not to move to Montana. Number 1, do not move to Montana if the Second Amendment makes you uncomfortable. The Second Amendment is the right for US citizens to keep and bear arms. And Montanans are very passionate about it. They protect it, they take it very seriously. So if you are uncomfortable with this, Montana's probably not the place for you. Montana ranks number 1 amongst all the states in gun ownership, with 66.3% of adults in households owning a gun. And research suggests that in America, of those who do own guns, typically it's 3 per adult. So if you do the math with how many residents we have in Montana, how many of those people are adults, you can go to the blog post if you want to really delve deep into this. You are looking at a total, a very conservative total, by the way, of 1,670,877 guns in Montana alone. And again, that's a very conservative number. Montanans love guns. And in Montana, you are allowed to open carry without a permit. And while I don't really see a lot of open carry here in Flathead County, I do know that people do, but even more so, I know that people conceal carry. For that, you do need a permit. You have to be a US citizen. You have to have resided in Montana for 6 months, be 18 years or older, and take a safety class. I know that most anywhere I go, somebody is carrying a gun. And if that thought bothers you, you probably don't want to live in Montana. I'm actually comforted by it. Since moving here, we've made a lot of friends, and over the course of time, they've been like, oh yeah, I pack. And I'm like, oh, okay. But I know these people, they're great people. Their heart is to protect the ones that they love. And I know that they would if the need ever arose. So for me, it's comforting. But if it's not for you, then Montana is probably not the place for you. Also, to be aware of, Montanans love to hunt. And so you need to, if you have kids, prepare them. The elementary schools during hunting season, they'll have a wall of fame where kids can bring in photos of them and their hunt. In the sporting goods stores, you'll also see something similar to this. Number 2, don't move to Montana if you don't love winter. Okay, this seems like a no-brainer. But I was just talking to one of my coworkers at the airport the other day, and she said, people have been buying properties sight unseen here in Montana this year. And the guy was talking and saying how he liked the little bike park up on the mountain that he took the chairlift to, and somebody mentioned to him that, oh, that's the ski resort. And he looked at them and was like, wait, you guys get snow here? I don't know how that's possible in this day and age with Google. I really don't. But I guess there was this one experience where I was looking for an Airbnb and I booked one, and I didn't even think to check if it was smoking or non-smoking, just because in the US, everything's non-smoking now, right? So maybe if you just never lived in a place with snow, it's not a thought that comes up, but Montana gets a lot of snow. And we have about 5 to 6 months of colder weather, and shorter days and gray days. January is the coldest month in Montana, but the temperature varies greatly between eastern Montana and then western Montana or Flathead County. Average low in eastern Montana during January is 2 degrees, whereas here in Flathead County you're at 22 degrees. So it really isn't that bad. I moved from the Midwest, and when I looked at that, like maybe 10 degrees colder than what I'm used to. However, if you're from a sunny state, then Montana's probably going to be difficult for you if you love that sunshine. We rank 45th in sunshine amongst all the states. Currently, if you live in Washington, Oregon, Maine, or Vermont, you have less sun than we do here. If you live anywhere else, you get more sunshine than we do, and that's something to consider, because I know with a lot of people that can affect your mood, that can affect depression. Definitely take that into consideration before moving here. And you guys, even if you love winter, you have to find a winter sport or hobby, or 2 or 3 or 4 of them, to keep you sane in the winter time. And Montana has plenty of them to choose from. We have downhill skiing, cross-country skiing, snowshoeing, dog sledding, snowmobiling, sleigh rides, ice fishing. And even if none of those work, I have Costco sells the little trek things you can put on your boots and go out walking throughout the winter. Just get a nice warm coat, put those on, and many days it's fine to just walk through your neighborhood if that's all that you can do. All right, you guys, moving on, number three, do not move to Montana if you don't own an all-wheel drive or four-wheel drive vehicle. So if you have a hybrid or a rear-wheel drive vehicle, I don't even know if they still make those, but it's time to get rid of that, sell that wherever you are, because nobody's gonna buy it here, and pick yourself up something that is more practical for the area. So most people here own either a pickup truck or the Subaru is like the state car. I think you see them everywhere. We don't own either. However, both of our vehicles do have four-wheel drive or all-wheel drive, and they also have that semi-automatic transmission, which is really important when you're going down a mountain, and also learn how to use that. I cannot tell you how many people I'm going to the Sun Road this summer were just burning their brakes all the way down the mountain. Also, in Montana, we have a lot of dirt roads with huge potholes, and my absolute least favorite dirt road is the washboard. However, you will want to take those because some of those lead to some of the best hikes and lakes and fishing. So you definitely want a car that has the clearance and the ability to traverse those so you can enjoy all that Montana has to offer. Additionally, if you've had some prior experience driving in snow, that would be really helpful here. If you live in the city or on a bus route, then having an all-wheel or four-wheel drive vehicle plus some snow tires is probably all you're gonna need. However, if you live out in the country, you are probably going to want to invest in some studs. You can put studs on your tires for the winter season, or get a good set of snow chains and put those on as needed. Also, another thing to be prepared for is driving at night. It's not like other places. The roads aren't lit, and the speed limits are fast, and the roads are curvy, and they don't have guardrails, a lot of them. So get familiar with using your brights and flicking them on and off with oncoming traffic. And then also deer. You're gonna hit a deer if you live here at some point. So a steel bumper or a winch can come in really handy and be a great investment for you, so that the deer kind of just bounces off and you go on your way without a lot of expense to your vehicle. All right, you guys, number four, don't move to Montana if you don't respect nature and love the outdoors. I think that pretty much goes without saying, but the nitty gritty of that does not. So when we were driving across the country to move here, we stopped at a bed and breakfast in Red Lodge, Montana. The host was nice enough, but he did mention to us while we stayed there that we had a lot to learn if we were going to live and survive in Montana. And while I felt he was being a bit overdramatic, and I still do, he had a good point. So when in Montana, I see people do things all the time that are just not smart for the area. So in Glacier National Park or Mount Ineos, people climbing out on like snow piles to get a photo or a little closer. The photo's not gonna be any better there, and that snow pile could just drop at any moment. So we've had stories of people that were getting photos by a river and slipped and fell in. Well, that river led to a waterfall just shortly down, and that's not where you want to fall into a river. So just kind of thinking ahead. There's nothing to be super afraid of. You just need to be wise. People getting too close to wildlife, people going off trail to take a shortcut and sliding down a shale hill and not being able to get out and having to call emergency rescue. Also, when you're driving, a lot of times you may not get cell service. So being prepared for that. If you're gonna go backcountry camping and hiking, you might wanna invest in some sort of satellite communication device because your cell phone is probably not going to work. You also want to let people know where you're going, when you plan to be back, the route that you're taking. I hate to admit that when we first moved here, we did a few hikes without bear spray. It was summer. There were busier hikes in Glacier. After a few hikes, I got the bear spray, but probably for a couple years, we only carried one bear spray. And it wasn't until I heard several bear stories in the news here, which, by the way, it's not common. Just so you know, just if they get startled, like a biker that comes around a curb and there's a bear, bam. Hearing those stories, and usually people have somebody else with them, but only one of them had the bear spray, which happened to be the one that was in the situation with the bear. So after hearing those, I'm like, we should have two people carrying bear spray. That would be smart and so easy. And just pay attention to locals and learn from them. One of my friends here, she grew up here, and even just walking with her, I'm just not paying attention and coming up on a curve. She's making noise. She's always aware. Like, she's spotting deer elk and snakes far before I am. I'm just walking right into them. Also, please familiarize yourself with the leave no trace policy. There are 7 points to the leave no trace. They're all kind of common sense, but so often overlooked. And I saw this here in the news. It made me so sad. People just graffitiing Zion National Park and all these beautiful places. And I'm like, what are you thinking? Don't do that. Sustainable travel, keep it nice for generations to come. All right, and number 5, don't move to Montana if you wanna change it. A lot of times with my whole moving to Montana guide, I would get some pretty worked up comments from locals about not wanting people coming here and trying to change everything. And that's fair. I think it's human nature to try to change things sometimes. We come in and we think we know better. So, a couple questions for you. Why would you move to Montana if you don't love it? And if you love it, why would you want to change it? And if you do want to change it, then Montana is probably not the right state for you. So that covers it. That's my list of 5. It's by no means an exhaustive list. However, if you listen to that list and you still feel like Montana is calling you, then it probably is. It's probably a great place for you to call home. You just have a little bit more research to do. It is a very different learning curve, moving to a city in Montana versus the country versus off-grid living. So that's definitely something to consider. And then you just have the question of where in Montana, because Montana is such a big state and it is so diverse. If Flathead County area interests you, it's in northwestern Montana. It stays a little bit warmer here. It's absolutely beautiful. Then definitely check out I'll put a link at the end of this to the start of my Montana Living Moving to Flathead County guide. And I go through 5 different cities in the area and their surroundings. I do cost of living and schools and recreation and shopping and dining and all of that good stuff. And if you feel like I missed something or left it out, leave that comment below. If you have any questions, leave them below. I love interacting with you guys. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you get notified when the next video drops. And you guys have an awesome week. I'll see you next time.